everyone at Divine Days. Welcome back to Divine Digi Channel. This week I've been making newspaper art, which just looks really quite pretty on the grey background. So I've stuck all different cuttings and torn bits of newspaper on a piece of card. If you want to do this yourself and you don't have any card, remember cereal boxes, you can get a nice piece of A4 card from there. So I've glued all of that on, and then I've just doodled with permanent marker this nice tree trunk, a lady with her back to us, and a little dog with his back to us. I'm not the world's greatest drawer, so this actually is. This smudge is a little dog. And then I've used nail varnish to just create this nice leaf effect with all different colours. And I just think it's really nice because we've got the grey dull background with all the little bits of COVID information, and on top a nice tree to show that there's still beauty around us, and the lady and the dog just waiting patiently like what we are all doing at the moment. So I'll show you how I started. Piece of card, gluing all bits of ripped newspaper on top. Just got to finish this last piece. I'm using PVA glue, but you can use prick stick, any kind of glue that you can find. Remember, flour and water makes a good glue. Need two pieces. Just all bits of ripped information. I'm just using a little paintbrush to pop on to show you. Doesn't have to be perfect. In fact, the fact that it's not perfect makes it a little bit better. And just stick those on. And there you have your background for you to do a drawing on, or add a rainbow for our key workers to show our appreciation. And you can use, when it's like this and it's dry, and it takes a few hours to dry, you can use felt tip. So that goes over nicely if you wanted to create some rainbow on top. Obviously, you'd be doing it not upside down. So when it's rough like this, you can actually use different kinds of things to put on top. So even crayon will work nice on top. Or if you wanted to just simply have it black and white, you could use biro will work on this as well. I've used permanent marker there to create a tray. Don't forget to put the notches in so it doesn't look like one huge leg. Okay, what? Or you could just simply have plain black. This is a branch. And then you could have a silhouette kind of design. Stick a little bird on the top. Again, I'm not great at drawing, but you can have this kind of effect, just black on newspaper, or fantastic colours. And when it's in this stage, when it's just glued on, like I say, you can use the felt tips, crayons, chalk, all different kinds. But if you want this glossy effect, like here, what I did on this one was, once it was at this stage, I covered the entire thing in glue. And that was literally just going over, just painting the whole thing and going over it. Took a few hours to dry. But what happens is, with this PVA glue, and if you're going to buy PVA glue, remember, sometimes it's called children's water-based glue or children's glue. It acts as a kind of varnish. So you have sort of the rough effect. And then once it's covered in glue, you will end up with a kind of, don't know whether you can say, like a glossy effect. Now, when it's covered in glue and you do have the glossy effect, it'll be hard to use felt tips and crayons. So what I've used here is sticking with the permanent marker and nail varnish, because then you've got the shiny effect from the enamel and then the shiny background here. So, let's move that up a minute. Can I? Yeah, kind of. Now, so to create this really, really easy, because it's literally going to be, just make a little bit for branches, a few lines to create your tree trunk. And then you can leave all of this. You don't have to go into branches or do twigs or anything, because once the nail varnish is on, it'll cover this area here. So, to stop it looking too much just like lines, if we just add some more here. Maybe one there. Really easy. Some shade in here. A bit of shade in there maybe. Just to identify the roots in the trunk. And yeah, I don't want to bore you, you get the effect. So you've got your tree trunk. Can add little bits later. So using nail varnish, this was really easy. This was literally just dotting. In the area that you want. So if you want the leaves to hang down, just take your dots over. Remember that sometimes there's leaves on the little bits that stick out of the trunk. It doesn't have to be great, you know, just dot it on. Different colours. Because we've got such a sad background, we want to brighten it up a little bit. And that's the start of your colourful leaves. And then keep going. Just adding different colours in between all the dots. Using L'Oreal, okay. The more colours you have, the more wonderful it'll be. Now, I don't want to bore you by spending the next half an hour putting little dots of nail varnish on, but you can kind of see how it's developing, and you can see how once you've put your different colours in, it gives you this effect. And I've just done another couple of dots down here in the same colours that I've done here, just to show that the leaves have fallen. And I just chose any nail varnishes that I had. I didn't specifically choose certain colours, because I just thought it really doesn't matter what colours is going on as long as it's colourful. So you can see how it sort of, how it can develop really easy to do. It doesn't have to be nail varnish, it can be acrylic paint. Or if you're not going to paint over it and you're going to use, and you're just going to keep it like this, even water-based paint will go over that and it'll still look nice. So, and then just carry on until your area where you want your leaves to be is completely covered. Really easy. Once you've got your background and you've done your tree trunk and you've done your leaves, at the moment doesn't seem to be fantastic, but the more you carry on, the more you seem to notice a development, and then you end up with this. Like I say, I'm not the world's best drawer, so you can do whatever drawings you want, or you can just simply keep it as a tree. Just to show that there is still life out there and still beauty. And it's a great thing to try. And it looks really nice when it's finished. So, hope you enjoy doing your newspaper art. And let us take some pictures of what you've created and send them to Divine Days Creative Arts or on Facebook page, or Divine Digi, or divinedays.com, and we'll have a look and we'll see what we've all created. And until next week, bye bye.